Laowa has two interesting 9mm lenses. Let's learn more about them.
The Cinema 5D virtual show is brought to you by B&H, the professional source for all your video needs. CVP, the leading specialist in creative cine, video and photo solutions. Sattler, set your ideas in motion. Blackmagic Design, creating amazing solutions for film, post-production and television. And Tilta, arm your camera.
Hi, I'm Johnny from Cinema 5D and welcome to our virtual show. Today I'm here with Kevin from Laowa. Kevin, how are you?
Good, how are you?
I'm very fine, thank you very much. And you have two unreleased lenses that you want to share some information about them with us. So let's go. Tell me about the first lens.
Okay, so this is going to be our biggest launch of the year. It's a 9mm f5.6 full-frame wide-angle lens. So let me repeat, this is the widest rectilinear lens that has ever been designed for full-frame cameras. It's not a fisheye, it's not a Super 35 or APS-C lens, it's a full-frame rectilinear lens. So it's designed primarily for landscape photographers who take like awesome, impressive landscape pictures. So it's ultra-wide, a one-of-a-kind 135 degrees ultra-wide angle of view. And it's super tiny and compact. If you look at here, it's only 0.8 pounds. The total length is only 66 millimeters, so it's super small. Together with the ultra-wide FOV, it also have a very close focusing distance. The closest it can focus, it will be 12 centimeters, counting from the subject to the sensor. So it's literally like this. You can still focus. So it can be served as like a mini macro lens. It comes with Sony E-mount like this. Right now I'm putting it onto the Sony A7 cameras. It also comes with Leica M and Nikon C-mount. It's actually the first native Leica M mount lens that we have ever produced.
Okay, any plans to introduce more mounts in the future?
Apart from the three mounts that I just mentioned, we are also considering developing it for the L mount for Sigma FP and also the X1H, but it all comes down to whether the is there any like strange effect on the sensor, because right now the lens does not come with Canon L mounts, because we've tested it and we found that the quality is not does not perform as good as the other mounts when it's on the Canon R sensor. So right now it only comes with Sony E in the concept and like I am.
Is more a lens for photographers or for video makers?
It's more for photographers because of the ultra wide angle of view. It's more for like landscape architecture or interior design, but not really for people shooting for videos, because the whole perspective will be a little bit odd.
The demand or the idea to do such a lens, is it coming from you guys or it's from the market?
Most of our lens that we design is we heard from the photographers from the market, and they are trying to have a lens which is compact, which is easier to carry, that they can use it for most purposes. And some photographers with feedback to us that the lens that are existing in the market is not wide enough for them to capture everything in one go.
When it comes to engineering of the lens itself, how do you keep actually the lines completely straight? Because that's the idea, that's the strength in your lenses.
Right, I'm pretty sure a lot of like photographers will ask us like whether this new 9mm lens is a 0D lens, because most of our wide-angle lens in the past is what we call 0D. And to be honest with you, this is not a 0D lens, because we treat that 0D thing is very seriously. Although this the distortion weight of this lens is already a lot better than most of the wide-angle lens in the market, but it's not a 0D. It's not like it's close to zero, but it's still very good, very well corrected.
Any chance to see that type of lens with autofocus in the future, or any of your lenses? Because so far you're really concentrating on manual lenses.
We are working on it. I mean, autofocus lens is one of our target, but it takes a little bit of time.
Let's talk quickly about the price and availability of that lens before we move to the next one.
The price of this lens is not set yet, but it will be less than $1,000. It will start shipping in around late June.
Oh, just around the corner. That's really, really nice to hear.
Right, and one additional feature that I would like to tell everybody is that not only the lens itself is super, super tiny and compact, and we understand that when landscape photographers, they want to take pictures, they will like to use filters. So although this lens has a bulgy front element that you cannot use it with screw-in filters, but we work with another manufacturer to design a filter holder that you can use it on the lens, and then you will be able to use 100mm wide slide-in filters. It's an additional benefit because you don't need to carry like very bulky 150mm big glasses outside to shoot. And the fact that it can take 100mm filters, a lot of photographers already have it in their camera bag, is an added benefit.
Any chance to work with another manufacturer and actually add back-end filters? Because this is becoming, I don't want to say it's becoming really popular, but it's becoming a valid option to put an ND filter at the back of the lens.
It's possible. We have enough space at the back of the lens that you can use like some gel-in filters. But we will definitely take a look at it.
Because I think in the past you already had a lens that you added this type of filter to the lens.
Right, we have a 10 to 18 millimeter lens, which we have like a rear filter slot that you can put in screen filters. So that's this one, it's possible. We'll look into it.
Thank you. Okay, let's move into the next lens. Show me what you have.
Okay, so moving on, the next lens that I'm going to talk about is, again, it's a 9mm lens. But this one is so much different from the other one. So it's a 9mm T2.9 lens. It's a videography lens. It's actually a cine mod version of the existing 9mm f2.8 lens that we made it for still. And it has the same optical design. The only difference is it has a better mechanical design, which comes in handy for videographers to manipulate the focus and aperture control. So again, it's the same as the photo lens. It is a 0D lens. It has a close to zero distortion, and it has a super 35 coverage. So right now it's putting it on to my Fuji cameras. That's why it comes with Fuji mount. It also comes with Sony and Micro Four Thirds mount.
That sounds really, really great. I mean, I love those wide angle lenses, and I'm very happy to see that you have a wider selections of mounts to this specific lens. Let's talk about how fast is the aperture?
It's an f2.8 lens. It's a 9mm. So 9mm in super 35 coverage is going to be 113 degrees FOV. So it's still super wide. So it's good for people, you know, for running gun shooting, or because it's so compact, it's also good for like gimbal shooting. And people would like to do vlogging, it's good. And also people would like to do architecture interior, they will be able to take advantage of the 0D feature to take impressive footage.
Is it possible to put an ND filter at the front of this lens?
It comes with a 55mm filter thread here, so you can easily put on any like screen filters, ND filters, and you're good to go.
How about, weight-wise? How lightweight, heavy?
It is a super tiny little lens. It weighs only 247 grams, so it's like nothing when you put it onto your camera.
The construction of the lens, is it plastic or metal?
It's completely metal, and it also have like 0.8 mod gears on both of the rings, so it's going to be very handy for videographers.
And the degrees focusing, maybe I missed it if you mentioned it.
It has a 180 degrees focus throw. So when it compares to the other cine lenses in the market, it's more comparable. And it's because it's a wide angle lens, it's not need to be like, have a very long focus throw either.
Sure, but minimum focus distance?
It can focus really close, like the other wide angle lenses that we make. It can focus up to, you know, 12 centimeters away from the sensor. So typically it's right here.
And in terms of breathing, noticeable or not so noticeable if I want to change from minimum to maximum focus?
I would say the breathing is still visible. It's because it's still like a modified lens from our photo lens. But you know what? For wide angle, the breathing is not that pronounced when you compare to some telephoto lenses.
Good. Let's talk about pricing and availability.
So this lens will be sold at a little bit more expensive than the photo lens. The photo lens is retailing at $499. This one will be retailing at $599. and we expect to have it started shipping in around middle of June. Apart from the lens itself, it also comes with a genuine Pelican case. It comes with the lens, so it's better for people to go out for shooting.
Good. Kevin, thank you very much for the time you dedicated us. Two very interesting products. I'm really looking forward to see them in the market. And yeah, if there is nothing else to add, then it's thank you very much. Thank you very much, guys, for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. And until next time, hopefully soon. Thank you.